What goes around comes around. Karma is real. When I was a real little kid, starting at like age 9, we used to walk around and break car windows, car hopping. We used to open any door that was locked and steal the contents inside. Sometimes if we seen something inside and the doors were locked, we'd break the window and then get inside. Then we got into stealing cars. I remember this one car in particular. It was Halloween. We started out smashing pumpkins and then car hopping. And we get to this car, right? And the keys were right on top of the hood. So we take the keys and run, gather, like, figure out who's going to go back and take the car. So I was that guy that time. I ran back. I get in the car, screech out of there like a hot boy. I got to the corner, picked my boys up. We dipped down to another apartment complex. And it was like a high rise. We went posted up in the back parking lot trying to figure out just what we were going to do with this car. All we really did was joyride that whole night with the attitude that if a cop gets behind us, we were going to dip out. That would get into a high-speed chase and nothing good could come about with that, right? So we take the car back to our neighborhood and we park it at the co-op grocery store, right? The next day, my homeboy goes back and gets the vehicle and we get the car. And we joyride again all day long. We're probably like 15. And I remember we were making a right like on Bright Seat Road, right by the new Redskins Stadium. And there was a PG County cop like right here to my left at that intersection. I'm just staring at him and, like an idiot, staring at him. And boom, I hit the curb. Now the tire pops. So we pulled right next to this car dealership. I think it was a Luskin car dealership right on Bright Seat Road in Landover. We go in this car dealership, like five deep, and they let us use the phone, and we call my dad to come pick us up. He came and picked us up. What are y'all doing over here, Woody Woody Woo? We never got caught for it, ever. Well, my car just got stolen. 2018 Chrysler 300. Walk outside to leave dark and early. Threw my trash away. And I get to where my carport is, number 70, and I'm like, am I tripping? My car is nowhere to be seen. So, I got a real good attitude about stuff like this nowadays. So I came back in the apartment, and I started to pray. I said, God, please direct my thoughts, my actions, my emotions, and my attitudes. Then I said the serenity prayer and the acceptance prayer. And then, boom, dialed 911 and reported it stolen. And then, you know, handled all the stuff with the car dealer, with the car insurance, Progressive, you know. So, you know, everything's taking its place. So, you know, I text my boss. I'm like, you know, my car got stolen, so bear with me. So then, like, you know, time's ticking, and I'm playing a waiting game right now because nobody in the world's awake but me. I go in my room, and I start laying down and chilling, and I seen the sun start to come up, so I get up, and I go outside, and I see a mob of people on the other side of the apartment complex. I go over there, and about 15 people's car got broken into and robbed. Not broken into. Their doors were unlocked. So basically, any car that had an unlocked door got hit last night. They finished right at me. All right, so the cops are all over the place at this point. And the cop was, he was talking to me again, you know, about my situation. And I'm going to be quite honest with you. I'm going to keep it all the way real. I told them I don't want to press charges. These kids have the same mind frame that I used to have when I was a little kid. So I know exactly where they are. And the last thing I want to do is be a direct contributor to them going to prison. You know, so they're going to be charged with being in possession of a stolen vehicle without me being involved. They're going to be charged with whatever charges they get hit with all the cars they've broken into. Hopefully they don't get into a high speed chase and die. Hopefully they don't get into a crash and die because they're in a sports car. It's a Chrysler 300 Sport. You know what I mean? And to be quite honest with you, I've been praying for these boys, you know, and I just hope that they make it out alive and I get my car back. And if I don't, I don't. It's materialistic, right? But I told the cops I don't want to press charges. They're going to get hit with a list of charges without me being involved. And I'm not resisting the situation. I'm just letting it take place. There's nothing I can do about it except keep a positive attitude. You know what I'm saying? I learned good attitudes get positive results. You know what I mean? Law of attraction, right? So that's where I'm at with it. So I'm not pressing charges. I don't have a car right now. I'm waiting on a ride. But yeah, man, karma is real. Because this is exactly what I used to do, and it's exactly what happened to me. Yeah.